It is a fact that we were given the most glorious, powerful, everlasting, sacred name in all creation to call upon, to remember it, to pass it on to all generations. Exodus 3:15. And we don't even know it. By us not knowing it is the proof that Satan has deceived our fathers and us.
Jeremiah 16:19.
And we have too much pride to confess it. The name was a sound that came from heaven, the mouth and mind of the Almighty Creator. And Satan has told the Eden lie again. The Eden lie, you shall not surely die. The Eden lie he has told us is the name is too sacred to utter.
When you must utter the name, invoke the name to be delivered.
Just like they disobeyed and died in the 1,000-year day for disobedience, we too, for disobedience, will die the second death for disobeying this command. Thou shalt not take the name YHWH, thy Almighty, to falsify it. For YHWH will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name and change it. No. Hebrews 77:23 tell you that the word is not vain, but falsified. If we disobey this command, we are breaking all the commandments, and Satan knows it. Just like he knew a day to YHWH was as 1,000 years, and Adam and Eve died before the 1,000 years were over. They died in that day. The sound from heaven had to be transliterated. The Almighty was the first to transliterate his name for us 7 times in the Decalogue. With his own finger, he used Hebrew letters to convey the only sound given for salvation. Acts 4:12, Samuel 8:33-34, John 3:18, Joel 2:32. Paul called on that name that washed away his sins, Acts 22:16, as it washed away the blood from the veil once a year.